Although his current rehab schedule doesn't make UFC 300 fight look very likely, he may have real injuries. Look, everybody's angling to try to get Conor, right? And
for welterweight?
Yeah. Listen.
Bro, he's small.
I understand. But wouldn't you take it just for the money? I mean, that's what Leon
would
feel
yeah,
like.
If I was Leon,
sure.
Yeah.
Leon would feel like he has a big advantage. You know, he's a legitimate welterweight.
He would dust Conor.
And then he'd make a lot of money.
He would
dust
Conor.
If he could talk Conor into that. But Conor and Chandler is interesting, too. You know, that I guess it's actually going to happen.
That's so
cringy. And it's
going to
happen at your weight, which is bananas.
Listen.
That's bananas.
Somebody said something to him about, hey, like, we got a no name in me. I would fight Conor. You won't fight 85. Shit, man. Change my life. I'm going to fuck you up. fuck that dude up.
But he's fighting Chandler at 85,
you know the word,
who's
you know what,
not an 85.
You know what I'm not used to yet, Joe? The casuals that go, are you in Conor's weight class?
There's a big fight coming up this weekend, obviously. Sean Strickland and Dricus du Plessis. What do you think about that? That's your division.
Yeah, both very beatable. That's what I think. I like Sean Strickland. I like DDP, too. I'm going to go the American way. I hope the American boy keeps it here in America. But
Dricus is a very unusual guy.
He's a very unorthodox power puncher, like forward, but there's a lot of openings to clip him, and he doesn't have a granite chin, in my opinion. He could take a shot, but I don't think he's fought anybody that could test his chin yet. So besides, Robert Whitaker was a dog, but he had Robert's number, man. He had a good plan. And
he's deceptively technical.
Yeah, he's just exactly. So he knows where. I think he's a guy. Let's put it this way. I think he's a guy that knows what he's good at and knows how to get there quick, and that's why he comes out hot, because he knows how he's going to wear on you. I have a lot of respect for Sean. I don't like listening to him talk. He sounds like a drunk person to me, so I'm not like a, but.
Well, he also, like you, came from a very abusive childhood.
Yeah, no. And man, look at what he's done.
It's amazing.
You know, look at what he's done.
Were you shocked when DDP beat down Robert Whitaker like that?
I was surprised that he did it the way he did it. I didn't count him out, but I didn't have him winning. You know what I mean? I definitely thought that it was going to be close. It was going to be tough. I really did. A lot of people counted him out. I was like, that's crazy, bro. This guy's not, I think he was 20-2 or something like that.
Yeah.
I was like, man, this dude can bring it. Like, he's going to make it a dogfight. And I don't care how technical you are. When somebody makes it ugly, Your energy level's down, and you're not that technical no more.
I was very impressed.
I was surprised that you could take him down.
Yeah. He's a big guy, man.
Yeah.
There's a thing about being confident and being delusional or overconfident or not respecting your opponent. Yeah. And, you know,
everybody deserves it.
Yeah, I don't know if that's what happened with Adesanya and Strickland. I think Strickland is just that good. I really do think.
I don't think Izzy, like, sidestepped him as much as we think. I think people don't understand when you're in there and you got a guy that never fucking takes a step backwards,
right.
It throws you off. You never can plant.
Right.
So you're not hitting your power shots. You're not doing the damage that you would if you were dictating. Mm-hmm. You're not going on your terms when you're going backwards the whole time. And that's why I think DDP has a good chance, because he's going to fight for that center to walk forward.
Right.
He's a guy that walks forward. Sean walks forward. I just think because DDP kind of falls over his knee when he attacks, I think he's going to get Sean to move back.
Mm.
But for how long?
We'll see. I'm very interested to see who prevails.
I think he does well early.
The Abus Magomedov fight, I think that fight was one of the most impressive fights of Strickland's fight.
I do too. I think it was Abus, underwhelming to people though.
Abus comes out in that first round like a bat out of hell, but he just gassed out. I mean, he was gassed out at the end of the first round.
Yo, he was throwing bombs.
He was trying to take him out. I think Abus was just so used to taking guys out that he thought he could just put it on Sean. And he was hitting Sean with fucking fire.
Yeah.
He was hitting him. That dude's good, man. He's good. But Sean just wilted him.
Yeah.
He just wilted him.
Yeah,
He doesn't get tired. It's crazy when you have a guy who spars as much as Sean, because the bulk of Sean's training is sparring, and he spars hard. He's so accustomed to that. That's really like a fight all the time.
He knows himself very well.
Mm-hmm.
He knows what he's good at.
Yeah.
And he knows what he likes. He knows what works for him.
Yeah.
So why fix what's not broken, you know? So.
Did you know, guys, that you could watch all the future UFC and boxing pay-per-views at no extra cost if it weren't for the greed of big broadcasters? Well, here's the darkest secret they don't want you to know about. On iWatch Max, you could watch all PPVs with access to 12,000 live TV channels and latest movies and series. This allows you to cancel any cable subscription, save on pay-per-view fees, while putting money back into your pocket. Crazy, right? For more information, visit iWatchMax.com or scan this QR code.
What do you think Adesanya does when he comes back? Like, who does he fight? He's not going to fight Paulo Costa again.
Well, he's still ranked, right?
Of course.
Like, but why wouldn't you take him out of the rankings if he's saying he's not coming back for 3-4 years?
Because he's not really.
Right. So, I mean, that's why I'm asking that is like, I don't think he's going to sit out that long either. Like,
3 years is crazy. That would be a crazy thing to do. I mean, unless, look, I haven't talked to him. He may have like real injuries that need like real.
He fought, like we said, he fought so much, he was active. Yeah. I think that this fight happens this weekend. And I think maybe one or two more title fights, whoever is holding it. I think if DDP wins, there's a chance he slides in to fight Dricus just because of all that shit.
It could be. And also Hamzat. You got to wonder where Hamzat fits in that. I mean, obviously Hamzat beat Usman. They might. They might
think.
Yeah.
Well, he's got superstar power.
Yeah. He's got
power. Like I get like nervous watching him like with excitement.
Yeah.
Because I love watching him. It's his face. It's the way he looks.
When
it's
he's his smiling,
persona. He's like doing this shit. Yeah.
Smiling at him at the beginning of the fight.
He looks evil.
He does.
He's got the look of somebody that like. Man, this motherfucker's about it. And he is. He's tough. He's a gangster, man. He goes out there and he does his game and, you know, he's not a quitter. But
Adesanya injured. Chair's timeline for full-time return to training camp. Last time I didn't look return sooner than many expected, although his current rehab schedule doesn't make UFC 300 fight look very likely. Okay, so he is talking about coming back. So when it says he's injured, does it share what the injury is?
It doesn't say specific. I was just looking to hopefully share that, but it doesn't say specific.
Yeah, I think there's stuff that he's been dealing with.
So I got this injury and it'll take a while to recover.
A long time to recover and whatnot. Like, I'm like, what are you telling them? A smart coach who knows the injury exists will try to use it against you. So he's not going to tell anybody what the injury is. He says, so far I'm recovering very well and I'm on track. If he's got something that's that big, that's either like knees or back or neck, generally, or, you know, it could be other joints. But generally, when someone's got a significant injury like that and they need a lot of time off, it could be a back thing. It could be a knee thing. It
could be a gastrointestinal thing.
Yeah.
You never know. I mean, I think that's like, I had a lot of struggles with like stomach problems. Like,
did you?
Yeah, man. I always felt like I had like this crazy acid feeling in my stomach.
It said he's aiming to get back in the gym, training hard by the end of February. That doesn't bode well for fans hoping UFC 300 in April. No, I don't think he's going to be at UFC 300, but he might be in the June card when Conor returns. You know, they're going to want to stack that card up.
How do you think that goes?
Well, I don't like it that it's at 85.
Is it actually confirmed at 85?
I don't know.
I mean, he said that.
He's
but like,
drinking wine and talking shit with a Rolex on. Like, who knows? Who knows?
Bro, that man drinks.
He does.
That man drinks. That man does some stuff. But yeah,
he likes
drinks.
To party.
I don't see that's like.
And he's also, he's getting older as well. And he's also coming off the sauce. Right, so he gets on the sauce to recover from that bone injury. It's a significant injury. You snap your femur and your tibia, rather, and your fibula. You snap those in half, and your ankle's dangling.